Today, I have got my thoughts on season one of the LEGO City Adventures TV show, which recently came to Netflix, and I kind of got hooked on it. Not only because it's LEGO related, but the episodes were nice and short, so it wasn't too crazy long, and I actually finished the whole 20 episode season in about 3 days. Could have been sooner, but just really, they'd get long after a while. But I really enjoyed the show quite a bit. And the only real nitpicky problem that I have is the fact that they end the first season, at least for what's on Netflix, they end it on a really big cliffhanger. And it's just. That's really the nitpicky problem I have with this. The other thing that I actually like about this is some of the named characters, which you get a lot of them in the newer sets now, but the named characters add a lot more to the sets, at least the newer ones, for younger kids, which I get that's what the stuff was for. But it's like just looking back on the 2013 LEGO City Undercover game. I wish they would have done something like this with those, with Chase McCain and all the characters from the game series, and had done like a TV series with them. That would have been a lot more fun. And it's like, that's just. Those are just some of the things that I would have loved to see with the LEGO City Adventures TV show. And I just really like how this series has turned out so far. And I can't really say anything too extremely bad other than the really bad cliffhanger at the end of season one. Would have loved that they would have actually extended the episode from an 11-minute runtime to say probably three times that. But other than that, I really don't have anything bad for this otherwise wonderful series. And if you guys are wondering, I will be hopefully doing thoughts videos for the LEGO Ninjago Masters Ninjutsu TV series, which just dropped seasons 11 and 12 on Netflix as well. And I've started watching those again. So, hopefully, I'll be able to do an overall thoughts video for the entire series, all 12 seasons. And so far, for what I've seen for that, it's really good. I might watch season 10 over just to see if there's any connections. But other than that, I really like. I'm loving the Ninjago series and always have, but I've never really gotten behind the sets. But that's what I've got for a little bit of an update for you guys and a thoughts video for the LEGO City Adventures TV show. So you guys can tell me your thoughts on this video in the comment section below and just like and subscribe for more because I will do more in the future.